Good day, dear students. In this video, we shall see about the Union Judiciary, the structure of Union Judiciary and the judicial system in India. As per the Constitution, there shall be a Supreme Court for India. And the Supreme Court shall consist of a Chief Justice and until Parliament bylaw prescribes a larger number of justices, not more than 25 judges can be the judges in Supreme Court of India. So as long as the Parliament decides to increase the number of justices in Supreme Court to be more than 25, as long as that, the maximum number of judges for Supreme Court can be 25. And every judge of the Supreme Court shall be appointed by the President under his seal, and that will be after the consultation with the judges of the Supreme Court and of the high courts in the states. So President may deem it necessary for the purpose and shall hold the office until he attains the age of 65 years. So the judges of the Supreme Court and the judges of the high courts are appointed by the President, and the retirement age shall be 65 years. Beyond 65 years, they cannot work. However, provided that in the case of appointment of a judge other than Chief Justice, the Chief Justice of India shall be consulted by the President, and provided that the judge may, by writing under his hand addressed to the President, resigned from his office, or the judge may be removed from his office in the manner provided in the clause 4. The age of a judge of the Supreme Court shall be determined by the authority and in manner by Parliament as per the law provides. There are certain minimum qualifications to be appointed as the judge of the Supreme Court of India. They are as follows. He shall be the citizen of India. The person who is being appointed as the judge of the Supreme Court shall be citizen of India. He shall have at least 5 years of experience as judge of the High Court or of two or more such courts in succession, or he has been for at least 10 years an advocate of the High Court, or of two or more such courts in succession, or is in the opinion of the President a distinguished jurist. A judge of the Supreme Court shall not be removed from the office except by the order of the President, passed after address of each house of the Parliament and supported by the majority of the total membership of the house and by a majority of not less than 2/3 the members of that house present, and voting has been presented to the President in the same session for such removal on the grounds of the misbehavior or incapability of the justice. The Parliament may by law regulate the procedure for presentation of an address for the investigation and proof of the misbehavior or incapability of the judge under the point 4 in the previous slide. However, every person appointed to be a judge of the Supreme Court will, before he enters his office, make and subscribe before the President or some person who is appointed by the president in his behalf, an oath or affirmation according to the forms that is set out by the constitution for the purpose of the house of the office of the judge that is mentioned in the third schedule. No person who has held the office as a judge of the Supreme Court shall plead or act in any court or before any authority within the territory of India. So if he is appointed as the judge of the Supreme Court, he cannot plead in front of any other court of India, or he cannot act in front of any other court of India. Appointment of the acting Chief Justice. So when office of Chief Justice of India is vacant, or when the Chief Justice is by reason of absence or not able to perform the duties of his office, the duties of his office shall be performed by any other judge of the court as the president may appoint for that particular purpose. So if the Chief Justice of India is not able to perform his duty, in that case the president can choose an alternative judge to act in his behalf. In the constitution there is also provision for appointment of ad hoc judges. So at any time there shall be a quorum of judges of Supreme Court available to hold and continue the sessions of the court. So at any given point of time there will be a quorum of the judges of the Supreme Court who will hold office and will continue the activities, day-to-day activities of the Supreme Court. And the Chief Justice of India may, with the consent from the President and after consultation with the Chief Justice of other high courts concerned, request in writing attendance at the sittings of the court of an ad hoc judge for such period that he thinks is necessary and justifiable. And a judge of High Court may duly be qualified for appointment of judge of the Supreme Court and can be designated by the Chief Justice of India. It is also the duty of the judge who has been designated as the judge of the Supreme Court to give priority to other duties of his office to attend the sittings of the Supreme Court and at the time for the period for which his attendance is required. So attending the sittings of the Supreme Court is of utmost importance. While so attending, he shall have all the jurisdiction, powers, privileges and will discharge the duties of the judge of the Supreme Court. He will be referred to as the judge of the Supreme Court. In our constitution, there is also a provision for appointing a retired judge at certain sittings of the Supreme Court. So it is clearly mentioned as below. The attendance of retired judge at sittings of the Supreme Court, notwithstanding in this chapter, the Chief Justice of India may at any point of time, with approval of the President, request any person who has held the office of the judge of the Supreme Court or a federal court or who has held the office of a judge of a high court and is qualified for the appointment of the judge of the Supreme Court to sit and act as a judge of Supreme Court. So Chief Justice of India can request a retired judge of Supreme Court or a high court to act as a judge of the Supreme Court, and such person can be requested. And while sitting or acting, he will be entitled to the allowances as the president may think fit, or he will get all the allowances that is pertaining to the judge of the Supreme Court. And he will also have all the jurisdiction, powers, privileges, but will not be deemed to be a judge of the court. He will have all the privileges, but he will not be deemed as the judge of the lower court. He will be considered as the judge of the Supreme Court. And provided that nothing in this article shall be deemed to require any person to sit and act as a judge of the court unless he consents to do so. So you cannot force anyone to be the judge of the Supreme Court. He also, the judge also has to agree or give his consent to be the judge of the Supreme Court on request of the Chief Justice of the Chief Justice of India. Supreme Court is considered as the court of record. Okay, so whatever happens in the Supreme Court will be recorded, and it has the power of all such courts, and including the power to punish a person for contempt of Supreme Court. So Supreme Court is considered as a court of records, and it has all the powers of the court, including punishing a person for contempt of Supreme Court, contempt of itself. The seat of Supreme Court is in Delhi, New Delhi, the national capital, or any such place or places as the Chief Justice may think suitable with the approval of the President from time to time. So the location of the Supreme Court of India is New Delhi. However, the Chief Justice, with prior consent and approval of the President, can move the court to some other location. The original jurisdiction of the Supreme Court is mentioned in the clauses as mentioned below, as per below. The subject of the provision of this Constitution, the Supreme Court shall, to the exclusion of any other courts, have the original jurisdiction in any disputes between Government of India and the Government of other states. And it can be more than one, or it can be with one state or with multiple states, or between the Government of India and any state or states on one side and one or more other states on other sides, and also between two or more states. So Supreme Court has jurisdiction in the cases between Government of India and Government of other states, Government of India and Government of one or more such states, and between two governments of two different states. And in so far the dispute involves any question, whether of law or fact, on which the existence or extent of a legal right depends, provided that said jurisdiction shall extend to a dispute arising out of any treaty, agreement, engagement, covenant, sanad, or other similar instruments which has been entered into and executed before the commencement of the Constitution, and it continues in operation even after the commencement of the Constitution, or which provides the said jurisdiction, shall not extend to such a dispute. Appellate jurisdiction of Supreme Court in appeals from high courts in certain cases. So if an appeal is lying in Supreme Court from any judgment, decree or final order of the High Court in the territory of India, whether in a civil court or a criminal court or any other proceedings, and if the High Court certifies this under the Article 134A, then that case involves a substantial question of law or question to the Constitution as per the interpretation of the Constitution, then In such cases, it can be brought to the Supreme Court. And whether a certificate is given to any party in such case may appeal to Supreme Court on the ground, and any such questions as mentioned above is wrongly decided also, the person can go to appeal to Supreme Court. The appealing jurisdiction of Supreme Court in appeals from high courts in regard to civil matters. So, an appeal shall lie in the Supreme Court from any judgment or decree or final order in civil proceedings of a high court in the territory of India if the high court certifies that under Article 134A, means even after getting a certification or dissolution on a case from high court, the person can still appeal at Supreme Court. And that case involves substantial question of law or general importance, and in the opinion of the High Court, the said question needs to be decided by the Supreme Court. So if High Court refers it to the Supreme Court, and notwithstanding anything in this Article 132, however, any party appealing to the Supreme Court under the Clause 1 may urge one of the grounds in such appeals that a substantial question of law has to interpretation of the Constitution been wrongly decided, or notwithstanding anything in this article to appeal shall, unless Parliament by law provides, if the Parliament allows, then it can lie with the Supreme Court from the judgment, decree or final order of the judge of the High Court. Like how we saw in the previous slide, the jurisdiction of the Supreme Court with respect to civil matters, similarly, the appealing jurisdiction of the Supreme Court with respect to criminal matters is explained in this slide. Okay, so the Constitution mentions that an appeal shall lie to the Supreme Court, or an appeal can be made to the Supreme Court from any judgment or final order or sentence in criminal proceedings also of a high court in the territory of India, provided that the high court has an appeal reversed an order of acquittal of an accused person and sentenced him to death. Previously he was not given death sentence, in high court he was given a death sentence, in that case he can go to Supreme Court, he can appeal at the Supreme Court, or has withdrawn a trial before itself or any case from any court that is subordinate to its authority and has such trial convicted the accused person and sentenced him to death. So if a person is sentenced to death also, he can go to Supreme Court and appeal. And certifies under the Article 134A that the case is fit for the appeal of the Supreme Court, provided that appeal under Clause C shall lie subject to such provisions as may be made in the behalf of the Clause 1 of Article 145, and such conditions of the High Court are established or required. Okay, and one more case is Parliament by law may confer to the Supreme Court further powers to entertain and hear appeals from any judgment, final order or sentence in a criminal proceeding of the High Court within the territory of India, subjected that the conditions and limitations are specified in such a law. So in last three slides you could understand like which and all cases can be appealed to Supreme Court even after it is heard from the High Court and the lower courts. Special leave to appeal by the Supreme Court. So notwithstanding anything in this chapter, Supreme Court can at its discretion grant special leave to the appeal for any judgment, decree, determination, sentence or order in any cause or matter passed by any lower court or tribunal within the territory of India. So it can tell that until the further hearing or Supreme Court decides to hold the previous judgment that has been given from a lower court. But however, nothing in the Clause 1 shall apply to any judgment, determination, sentence or order passed by or made by any court or tribunal constituted by under the law relating to the armed forces. Okay, so this clause 1 does not apply to the armed forces. And review of judgments or orders by the Supreme Court subject to the provisions of the Constitution and laws made by the Parliament. Any rules made under Article 145, the Supreme Court has the power to review any judgment pronounced or the order that is made by it. So it can always review the judgments made by it. Enlargement of the jurisdiction of the Supreme Court. So Supreme Court jurisdiction or increasing the jurisdiction of the Supreme Court is explained here. Supreme Court will have further jurisdiction and power with respect to any matters in the union list as the Parliament may by law confer. So Parliament can give extra rights to the Supreme Court. And Supreme Court will have such further jurisdiction and powers with respect to any matters of the Government of India and Government of any state, and may by special agreement confer the Parliament by law provides that for the exercise of such jurisdiction and powers by the Supreme Court. So Supreme Court's jurisdiction can be increased by the Parliament, and Constitution gives this option in this article. Conferment of Supreme Court of powers to issue certain writs. Parliament again can confer Supreme Courts with special powers to issue directions, orders or writs, including writs in matters of habeas corpus, mandamus, prohibition, quo warranto and certiorari, or any of them for any purposes other than the ones that is mentioned in clause 2 of article 32. So the Parliament can confer Supreme Court with extra powers. Transfer of certain cases. So where the cases involving the same or substantially the same question of law are pending before the Supreme Court or one or more high courts, or before two or more high courts, and the Supreme Court is satisfied on its own motion, or an application is made by the Attorney General of India or by a party to such case, or a party who is a bearer in such case, then such questions are substantial questions of general importance, and Supreme Court can withdraw the case from such lower courts or the case pending before the High Court and dispose of all the cases by itself, provided that Supreme Court may, after determining the said questions of law, return any case so withdrawn together with the copy of its own judgment. So Supreme Court can give judgment in such cases and on such questions to the High Court from which the case has been withdrawn, and High Court can, on the receipt of the judgment, proceed to dispose of the case in conformity with the judgment of the Supreme Court. So the Supreme Court has the right to call any case into its own court and give the judgment, and on the judgment it can give directions to the High Court as to whether to dispose of that case or not. And Supreme Court may, if it deems to fit expedient so to do for the ends of justice, transfer any case or appeal or any other proceedings pending before High Court to any other High Court. So Supreme Court can transfer the cases from one High Court to another High Court. It has the rights to do that. The laws that has been declared by Supreme Court will be binding on all the courts, that is High Courts, District Court, tribunals, etc. The law declared by Supreme Court will be binding on all the courts within the territory of India, in the power of President to consult with the Supreme Court. This is a special case wherein the President has the power to consult with the Supreme Court. At any point of time, if President thinks that a question of law has risen or it is likely to rise in such nature and for public importance, such questions are of public importance, then it is expected to then he can obtain the opinion of Supreme Court on such questions of law, and he may refer the question to the court for consideration, and court may, after hearing such issues and if it thinks fit, report back to the president about the opinion of the court. So if president has any dilemma about any questions of law, he can definitely refer it to Supreme Court, and Supreme Court can give its opinion to the president. And president may, notwithstanding anything in the provision of Article 131, refer a dispute of the kind mentioned in the said provision to the Supreme Court for opinion, and Supreme Court can, after hearing such cases and things fit, report back to the president for with its opinion. So president can refer to Supreme Court for the opinions at any juncture of time. The rules of court. So subject to the provision of the law made by the Parliament and the Supreme Court may from time to time, with approval of the president, make rules for regulating the public and citizens, and for the general practice and procedure of the courts, including rules to persons practicing before the court, rules to procedures for hearing the appeals and other matters pertaining to appeals, including time within which it has to be solved and heard, with which appeals to the court has to be entered, and also rules to proceedings in the court for the enforcement of the rights conferred in the Part 3 of the Constitution. So Supreme Court has the power to make rules has for the three clauses A, B and C. So the interpretation. The references to any substantial questions of law as to interpretation of the Constitution shall be construed as including references to the substantial questions of law as to interpret the Government Act of 1935 and the order in the councils or order made thereunder with the Indian Independence Act of 1947 or any order made as per that thereunder.